honeybees. It's your girl, your Judy, your boy, Gabe, aka Cutie, from Keeping It G100, only on Instagram. If you guys don't follow Keeping It G100 for all of your gossip, reality TV shows, and news, make sure that you guys go follow on KEEPNITG100. That's once again KEEPNITG100. And if you guys love what you see here, if you guys love my show, love what you guys are seeing, what you guys are watching, make sure that you guys subscribe, like, comment, do what you gotta do, okay? Market, send a message in a bottle, promote my page, do what you gotta do. And if you don't like my page, fuck you, bitch! I'm kidding. So I added a new little segment on my show, okay? And it's called High Times with Cutie, okay? This is me getting high with Cutie. I low-key was actually going to call it High Times with Cutie Pie, but then I was like, ooh, I feel like that's like too many words. Like, Cutie Pie, High Times, like, you rhyming too much, bitch. Don't do all that. Just say High Times with Cutie. So we are calling it High Times with Cutie, and what we are doing with this segment of our show is the fact that we are going to be talking about reality TV shows that just happened, reviews. We also going to be talking about some celebrity gossip. There's going to be little segments of that. So High Times with Cutie is just going to be me. Getting high and talking about bullshit, okay? We're gonna talk about first things first. We're gonna talk about Real Housewives of Potomac this past Sunday that just happened, okay? So let's talk about that. So Candace and her mom are actually just like me and my mom. They are actually going through a situation of trying to rebuild their relationship because clearly it has drifted away, honey, okay? So with that, they have been going to counseling. They've just been getting stuff together. You know, they have been trying to get Candace's mother to understand Candace's feelings. So I actually, low-key, I kind of was almost in tears because I'm like, oh my God, this is just like me and Mika, aka my mama. Me and my mom, actually, we used to be, I guess they used to, what's the saying, thick as thieves, okay? I used to, like I said in my first video, I was like her pocketbook, all of that. So once I grew up and like, you know, became the girl and she realized that she can't change my ass, she, you know, our relationship has drifted and, you know, she became very shady, very disrespectful. So like, you know, me being the person that I am, I just don't got time for the bullshit. So you're not going to try to disrespect me just because of the fact that you think that I'm your child and you could talk to me any type of way. No, ma'am, no hair. Okay? So, with that being said, I just feel like that me and Candace actually have some sort of similarity because of the fact that we both have mothers that don't really understand that mental health is kind of like a serious thing. And it kind of like confuses me because of the fact that Candace's mom is a therapist. So maybe she does know that it is a serious thing, but why aren't you? It's like, it confuses me with certain parents that they like practice these things outside of the household, but they don't practice it inside of their home. You know what I'm saying? The same thing with my mom. She's practicing, you know, the word of God and, you know, being peaceful and this and the third, but certain things that she's practicing and she's preaching isn't conducive of what's going on in her own home. So I just really hope that like this therapy and this therapy session with her and her mother, that just really like helps them out, because honestly, all we doing is getting older. We not getting younger. So you just keep on like having this drama and this attitude all the time. It's only hurting your child and yourself, because you could drift away one day and you still have the same relationship as your child and it's not helping. It's actually hurting. So with that being said, I just hope that they just fix it and they just, you know, with Jesus and therapy, honey, okay? Myself, I'm actually starting to go to therapy. My first therapy session is actually next week, thank God for Jesus. Because you got to realize that, honey, a bitch needs help, okay? You can't always be talking to your friends thinking that your friends got the answers. They don't always have the answers, sis, okay? You actually probably got to talk to somebody else that doesn't know you and doesn't understand everything that's going on so they can be like, no, maybe you did this, that, and the third. So I honestly am really excited about my first therapy session next week, and I'll definitely be updating y'all about that. But speaking of therapy, I think Ashley and Michael Darby need fucking couples therapy, honey, okay? let's talk about this, okay? Because I feel like Michael Lowkey, he's DL. It's been going too long for this whole gay thing with Michael and Ashley and their relationship. I mean, I'm happy that they had their baby. Congratulations to them and the new baby boy. But honey, Michael, baby, why are you grabbing people's tushies? That's just not hot. You done got accused for grabbing people's butts, and now, you know, apparently the charges got dropped, honey, okay? Thank God for Jesus. But that don't, you know, you just can't be grabbing people's butts and then saying that I want to suck his dick and this, that, the third, and thinking that's okay. All my, I don't know, not one straight friend that I got saying that they want to suck anybody other man's dick, okay? I got a few straight friends. I ain't never heard that, okay? Now, the grabbing of the butt, that's, you know, I mean, niggas will be niggas. You know, I feel like, you know, a little bitch, you know, like a little smack on the ass. That's like some football shit. Like, you know, but I mean, don't do that with me because, you know, I mean, okay. Smack my ass out of here, make smack back out of your cat, period. Okay. Okay. But with Michael, I just feel like that, you know, he needs to just either settle down, go to therapy, and figure out what's going on. If you bisexual, you bisexual, that's fine. We here for the bis, okay? Me, as a member of the LGBTQ, IT, PPP, ODD community, okay? We are here for you, okay? We are welcome you with open arms. We are here with the weed, okay? We with the weed pen, honey, okay? Okay, we here for you, sir. Okay, you and the baby. Y'all need to stop hiding in the closet like R. Kelly and come out. Okay, come out. We are here. Period. But honestly, if I was Ashley, I low-key would be pissed at Giselle. Because Giselle's ass, she's too goddamn messy. She be running her goddamn mouth too damn much. Why are you out here telling everybody Michael's business? That's not your place. But honestly, I feel like that's her role on the show. So you know that's definitely her role on the show. Like, why the hell you just out here just telling everybody's business about Michael? What about your business? Okay, with your man and your men's and your ex-husband, honey. Okay. What about that? Okay? But you don't want to talk about that, honey, okay? But you want to talk about Michael and Ashley and Candace and everybody else and Robin, your so-called best friend. You want to talk about her and her marriage, okay? But you have yet to be married again. You still got the last name Bryant, but Jamal's over here with tweet, tweetily, deep, 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 okay? Giselle needs to stop being shady. Okay, that's really my opinion with that. I love her to death, but she's just too shady for me. For me. Like, for real. She reminds me of myself. That's really what it is. So we're actually going to have another segment of High Times with Cutie. Next time, we're actually going to probably be talking about the ASAP Rocky situation with Trump and him still in Sweden, honey. We got to figure out to try to get ASAP out, okay? Because apparently they might be giving him some money if he's not guilty. But we'll talk about at the next episode of High Times with Cutie. Don't forget, guys, to subscribe. Oh, honey, this weed is fucking me up. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and also definitely say, hey, y'all, go follow Gabe at Keeping a G on YouTube, honey, okay? Definitely promote my page, y'all, and I will love you guys forever. Once again, follow Keeping a G on Instagram for all your gossip and news. KEEPNIT100. KEEPNITG 100. Only on Instagram. Thanks, guys, so much. Love ya! It's QDG, and I'm out!